Now we'll discuss about closed loop congestion control. As we stated earlier, that in case of open loop congestion control, it was the procedure of congestion prevention. And in case of closed loop congestion control, we have to assume that congestion has been already occurred. Now we want to come out from this congestion situation. That is why the loop is already closed. Loop pura ho gaya hai, congestion complete ho gaya hai. Now we want to break that loop. What are the procedures? First procedure is back pressure. Now what is back pressure? Directly if we consider this diagram, you can see there are few routers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 routers, and there is a source and destination. Now from source, someone is sending a packet to this destination computer. So suppose router 3 has detected the congestion. Router 3 ko pata chala hai ke there is a congestion. Now what router 3 will do? Router 3 will inform to router 2 by sending a special packet. राउटर थ्री राउटर टू को एक पैकेट भेज के बोलेगा कि मेरे ऊपर इतना प्रेशर मत डालो. सो दैट इज अ बैक प्रेशर. व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड बैक प्रेशर? इफ यू कंसीडर द प्रेशर डायरेक्शन, इट इज अगेंस्ट द डेटा फ्लो. दैट मीन्स सोर्स टू डेस्टिनेशन जो डेटा फ्लो था वो लेफ्ट टू राइट था, लेकिन राउटर थ्री जब राउटर टू को इंस्ट्रक्शन भेज रहा है तो वो राइट टू लेफ्ट है, इसलिए बैक प्रेशर, पीछे की तरफ प्रेशर दिया जा रहा है. एंड राउटर टू इन द सेम वे रिक्वेस्ट राउटर वन टू स्टॉप डेटा सेंडिंग. एंड फाइनली राउटर वन विल सेंड दिस रिक्वेस्ट टू सोर्स एंड सोर्स विल स्टॉप सेंडिंग द डेटा. सो this is the procedure of back pressure. Next one is choke packet. Now if you consider about back pressure, a back pressure method is only possible to implement only in the case of connection oriented system, jahan pe source to destination ka jo path hai wo pehle se fixed hai. Because of that, each router knows which is the previous router. सारे node को पता है इसका पीछे वाला जो node वो कौन सा है. ये तभी possible है when we are using the connection oriented system, क्योंकि जब तक हम लोग connection close नहीं करेंगे the path is fixed and everyone knows the previous node. But in case of connectionless system, एक बार कोई एक नोड, मान लो एक राउटर, send the data to the next router, there is no connection between the previous router and the current router. एक बार कोई एक राउटर डेटा भेज दिया तो इन दोनों के बीच में कोई कनेक्शन नहीं है. So in this case, connectionless system, it is impossible to know for a router which one is the previous one, which one is the previous router. Router can only know which one is the source. Uska piche wala jo router hai usko pehchanne ke liye koi data uske paas nahi hai, lekin uske paas jo hai source ka address hai, IP address hai. Kahan se usko milega source ka IP address? Whatever the packet router is receiving, there is in this IP packet, in the header of the IP packet, there is a field source address and destination address. So source address usse pata chal raha hai ke who is the source, who is the send, who is sending the data. Now that is why in case of connectionless protocol, whenever router 3 detects there is a congestion, router we will send a special packet which is known as choke packet directly to the source. एक स्पेशल पैकेट जनरेट होगा और वो डायरेक्टली सोर्स को भेजा जाएगा. दिस इज नोन एज चोक पैकेट. देन इम्प्लिसिट सिग्नलिंग. व्हाट इज इम्प्लिसिट सिग्नलिंग? राउट जो सोर्स है उसको खुद ब खुद पता चल जाएगा कि देयर इज अ कंजेशन एंड सोर्स विल स्टॉप सेंडिंग द डेटा. हाउ दिस इज पॉसिबल? In case of implicit signaling, whenever a sender will send some data, in response of that, what sender expects? Acknowledgement. जब भी कोई sender data send करता है तो उसके बदले में उसको acknowledgement मिलता है. And that acknowledgement must come to the sender within a certain period of time. ये हम लोगों का फ्लो कंट्रोल चैप्टर में जो ARQ था उससे हम लोगों को पता है ऑलरेडी कि व्हेनेवर एनी सोर्स वन सेंड्स डेटा इट एक्सपेक्ट्स द एक्नॉलेजमेंट अगेंस्ट इट विद इन अ सर्टेन टाइम पीरियड जिसको हम लोग टाइम आउट पीरियड कहते हैं. इफ विद इन दिस टाइम पीरियड द डेटा इज नॉट अवेलेबल देन द सेंडर वी ट्रांसमिट दैट डेटा. अगर ऐसा होता है कि कोई एक डेटा भेजा जा रहा है लेकिन उसके बदले में we are not getting acknowledgement for a while, kuch der ke liye hume acknowledgement mil hi nahi raha hai, so sender ko ye pata chalega, sender will assume that there is a congestion, that is why whatever data we are sending against that no acknowledgement is coming. So sender will implicitly know. Implicit matlab usko bahar se koi nahi bolega, implicitly know that there is a congestion and sender will stop sending the data. Next is explicit signal. In case of explicit signaling, some external source will tell the sender that there is a congestion. Now the question is, then what is the difference between this back pressure choke packet and this explicit signaling? In case of back pressure and choke packet, again we are sending explicit data to the sender to inform him about the congestion. So difference kya raha? The difference is, in case of choke packet and back pressure, basically we are sending a separate packet to give the information about the congestion, but sending another separate packet to inform about congestion is increasing the load on the network. जब भी हम लोग एक extra packet congestion हुआ है ये बोलने के लिए भेज रहे हैं sender को, इसका मतलब हम लोग data transmission को और increase कर रहे हैं. So we are putting more pressure whenever already there is a congestion, which is not desirable. तो हम लोगों को क्या करना होगा? मान लो A और B दोनों में, you can assume in this way. Suppose this is the source or this is the destination. Now source is sending the packet to destination, say through this router 3. Now somewhere near destination, this computer, whatever the computer is there, ये वाला जो computer है, ये भी source को data भेजेगा. Not necessary this destination is sending data. Someone is sending the data to this person, to this source computer. And when the data will be flown towards this source, suppose this data will come to this router. कोई भी एक डेटा भेज रहा है इस पर्सन को, इस कंप्यूटर को, अगर वो डेटा इस राउटर 3 के थ्रू फॉरवर्ड होता है इस सोर्स में, तो दिस राउटर इज एक्चुअली फॉरवर्डिंग द डेटा टुवर्ड्स द सोर्स. जब वो डेटा भेजेगा, जब वो आईपी पैकेट भेजेगा, तब उस आईपी पैकेट में एक बिट वो यूज करेगा टू inform about the congestion, which is known as the congestion bit. If the value of that congestion bit is 1, that means there is a congestion. If normally we put this congestion bit as 0 to indicate there is no congestion. So jab aisa koi packet aa raha hai router 3 ke paas jo isko forward karna hai, tab usi packet ka header ka ek congestion bit ko ye use karega source ko congestion hua hai ye samajhne ke liye, samjhane ke liye. That means this router is not sending any separate packet to inform about the congestion. So that is explicit signaling. Now this explicit signaling can be of two type, backward signaling and forward signaling. When backward signaling will be used, backward signaling actually hum logon ne jo kaha hai ki jab iske paas koi packet aata hai jo is person ko is computer ko bhejna tha, uska congestion bit ko 1 karke usne message de diya isko there is a congestion. Now that is backward because this is against the data flow. Data flow is direction left right, left to right ho raha hai, aur congestion ka jo is indication hai wo right to left ja raha hai. Lekin what is forward signaling? Forward signaling ka matlab जिस डायरेक्शन में कंजेशन हो रहा है, जिस डायरेक्शन में डेटा जा रहा है, हम लोग कंजेशन का जो इन्फॉर्मेशन है, वी विल सेंड द इन्फॉर्मेशन इन द सेम डायरेक्शन. दैट मींस इफ डेटा इज फ्लोइंग फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट, देन वी विल सेंड द कंजेशन इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट. सो इफ राउटर 3 इज डिटेक्टिंग द कंजेशन एंड इट सेंड्स द कंजेशन इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट, दैट मींस फ्रॉम राउटर 3 टू राइट साइड, finally it will reach this congestion information will reach to the destination. The congestion jo hua hai ye hum log kisko bata rahe hai, ye destination ko bata raha hai. Lekin what is the utilization of giving this information to destination? Basically we have to send this information to source, kyunki source hi data bhej raha hai. To agar data ka flow band karna hai, so we have to stop the data sending of source. Now in this method basically we are sending this congestion information to destination. So isme kya fayda hai, the trick is when destination will know there is a congestion, destination will intentionally stop sending the acknowledgement. Destination ab kya karega, acknowledgement bhejna band kar dega. And whenever destination will stop sending the acknowledgement, source will assume that there is a congestion, just in the same way it assumed it in case of implicit signaling. Jab source ko bahut der tak acknowledgement nahi milega, to source ye assume karega ki there is a congestion. So this is all about forward signaling and this is all about closed loop congestion control.